Hello students, welcome to IBS online classes. This is Arshdeep Kaur. Let's start with the important news items for today. Sabse pehle hum baat karenge regarding the solar charkha mission that was launched on the occasion of second United Nations micro, small and medium sized enterprises day on 27th of June by the President of India Ramnath Kovind. This mission will provide a subsidy of rupees 550 crores in the initial 2 years for 50 clusters, and every cluster will employ 400 to 2000 artisans. The main objective behind this solar charkha mission is to link 5 crore women to this initiative and generate employment in the rural areas and contribute to the green economy. A digital platform was also launched called Sampark Portal that will be helpful in creating a skill pool of workers and connecting the trained youth with job opportunities. So, here are the important points. The United Nations Micro, Small and Medium Sized Enterprises Day is observed on 27th of June. And on this day, the President of India, Ramnath Kovind, launched the Solar Charkha Mission in India. Then we'll move to next news. This is I Pledge for 9 Achievers Awards. So they were given recently to individuals and doctors from the private sector for their outstanding contribution and support in achieving the objectives of Pradhan Mantri Surakshit Matritva Abhiyan of safe motherhood to every woman in the country. The Minister of Health and Family Welfare, J.P. Nadda, gave away these awards. So, here are important points. Jo I Pledge for 9 Achievers Awards, they are given to people who have worked in the achieving objectives of Pradhan Mantri Surakshit Matritva Abhiyan, that is PMSMA, and this was given away by the Minister of Health and Family Welfare, J.P. Nadda. Then we'll talk about the Director General of International Organization for Migration, IOM. Antonio Vitorino, who is from Portugal, has been elected the Director General of IOM. So IOM jo hai, ye United Nations ki migration agency hai, and it is a leading intergovernmental organization in the field of migration. It provides services and advice to the governments and migrants, such as the humanitarian assistance, including refugees, internally displaced people. So headquarters of IOM are in Switzerland. So here are important points kya rahe, jo elect kiya gaya hai, Director General of International Organization for Migration. Unka naam hai Antonio Vitorino and he is from Portugal. Aur headquarters jo hai IOM ke, they are in Switzerland. Then we'll move to next news, that is regarding the United Nations Relief and Works Agency for Palestine Refugees. So India has pledged to give $5 million in assistance to the UN agency working for the welfare of Palestinian refugees to help bolster its severe funding crisis that is caused because of the US's cut in its annual aid. So a total of 20 countries will be helping the United Nations Relief and Works Agency for Palestinian Refugees. So, ye jo UNRWA hai, they work in the areas of Jordan, Lebanon, Syria, West Bank and the Gaza Strip for 65 years. The headquarters are divided between the Gaza Strip and Amman. So, yahan pe important points kya rahe? Jo United Nations Relief and Works Agency hai for Palestinian refugees, they work in the areas of operation of Jordan, Lebanon, Syria, West Bank and Gaza Strip. Jo inke headquarters hain, they are between the Gaza Strip and Amman, and India has pledged to give the $5 million in assistance to UNRWA. Then we'll move to next news, that is UNESCO's World Heritage Site. The Victorian Gothic and Art Deco Ensemble of Mumbai has been declared as the World Heritage Site by UNESCO on 30th of June. This decision was taken at the 42nd session of the UNESCO World Heritage Committee in Manama in Bahrain. So this makes Mumbai city the second city in India after Ahmedabad to be included on the World Heritage List. Now India has overall 37 World Heritage inscriptions. India stands second largest in number after China in terms of the number of World Heritage properties, and overall it is 6th in the world. So here are important points that are recently included as World Heritage Site by UNESCO, that is the Victorian Gothic and Art Deco Ensemble of Mumbai. So with this, India has become the second largest in number after China to be included in the number of World Heritage properties, and it is overall 6th largest in the world. Then we'll move to next news, that is 2018 International Day of Tropics, that is observed every year on 29th of June to raise awareness to the specific challenges faced by the tropic areas. So this day celebrates the extraordinary diversity of the tropics while highlighting unique challenges and opportunities the nations of the tropic face. It provides an opportunity to take stock of progress across the tropics, to share the stories and expertise and acknowledge the diversity and potential of this region. So here important points are what is 2018 International Day of Tropics. It is observed every year on 29th of June. Then we move to next news, that is Chairman of the Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs, CBIC. S. Ramesh, who is an IRS officer, has taken over as the new chairman of the Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs. So the Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs is the apex policy making body for indirect taxes. It is the apex body for administering the levy and collection of indirect taxes like central excise duty, customs duty, service tax, and for facilitating the cross-border movement of goods and services. It is a part of Department of Revenue under Ministry of Finance. तो यहाँ पे इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स क्या हैं जो सेंट्रल बोर्ड ऑफ इनडायरेक्ट टैक्सेस एंड कस्टम्स हैं उसके चेयरमैन रिसेंटली अपॉइंट किया गया है एस रमेश को सो स्टूडेंट्स दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर वाचिंग दिस वीडियो आई होप यू लाइक दिस वीडियो